Hi all, welcome to PowerShell for Penetration Testers at Pentester Academy. In this video, we will have a look at basics of functions in PowerShell. Let's have a look at simple usage of the functions. A function in PowerShell is defined this way, the keyword function followed by the function name. Let's create a function called add, and function name is followed by the statement or expressions to be executed. Let's just say 1 plus 3. As you can see, we created a function called add and it just adds 1 plus 3. Now, to call a function in PowerShell, we can do it just this way. Note that there was no need to add parentheses or anything else in front of the function name. We can call the function by just using its name without any parentheses or anything special. PowerShell allows to pass parameters to a function using a special array of parameters called args. For example, let's create a function called parameter add. Let's just call it param show, and let's just print the value of the args. Now if we call the function param show without a parameter, nothing will happen. And let's pass hi to it, it prints hi. That is, the value goes to the array $args. Since this $args is an array, that means we can use individual elements of this array in our function body. Let's create param add now and add args0 and args1. And now if we call param add with 3 and 7, the output is now 10. As you can see, again while passing the parameters, we just separated them by a space and nothing else. If you want, you can call or you can pass the parameters with parentheses and commas in the classical way, but let's just leave it for now. So this was the simple usage, $args usage. Now let's quickly move on to the declaring parameters part. Here we used $args, etc., but obviously we may like to declare complex parameters or parameters with a special name or type, etc. So for that, we can declare our own parameters. Let's declare $number1, num2, and let's just multiply these two. Now if we call the new function and pass, let's say, 2 and 6 to it, the function executed successfully. Now, let's see a quick difference between positional and named parameters. Declaring attributes of a parameter to assign them a position and other attributes would be covered in a later video. Here, a positional parameter means, let's define a new function called pos1 and let's make it to accept two parameters. Let's print the value of param1 here. Now, if we use -param1 and pass something to it, you can see that the first parameter was populated. This is similar to this thing, but So this thing means param1 has a position 0 and param2 has a position 2. But using the named parameters, we can always use this. We can pass param2 prior to param1 and param1 later on. As you can see, again, as expected, param1 has been printed. Again, when we called functions this way, we were using the positional aspects of these parameters. That is, we knew that 2 here will go to num1 and 6 to num2. And here we use the named attribute of the parameters. We specifically called param2 earlier and then param1. So that is all for this introductory video to functions. We will cover functions in details and small aspects at a time, because we would be using functions in further scripts a lot. If you are enjoying your time at Pentester Academy, please do recommend us to your friends and colleagues in the information security community.